just earlier, the fans on their feet as the national anthem rang out throughout the arena. We're coming at you from beautiful New York City as the Knicks prepare to take the home court. A quick check of our starting lineups. State Farm shows who will hit the floor first. Someone certainly will be keeping an eye on Jason Kidd.
Now, there have been a lot of great point guards in this game, and Jason Kidd is one of the all-time greats. He's so good at finding teammates, getting them the ball where they want. And if you're a high flyer as a teammate of his, just go to the rim, Kidd will throw that alley-oop.
Yeah, it's all part of the package that makes Kidd one of the greatest point guards of all time and recent time. I mean, he can do everything you want and more, and does it all really well.
So for the Mavericks, their last game, a win against Toronto.
And Kevin, what I like most about that win was their offensive creativity. They had a really varied approach to the game, and it worked well.
And they sure did shoot the ball well too, Steve, and that never hurts.
Kidd, no good. Yeah, Steve, you look at the standings for the past few years, the Mavs, one of the toughest road teams in the league. But Clark, last year they really struggled. They didn't have that same edge away from Dallas.
13-20 was their final road record, Kevin, and that's a far cry from what they're used to. It's really a big part of why they didn't win their division and had to settle for the seventh seed in the Western Conference playoffs.
Now at the break on the floor, you can see the teams that led the NBA in steals last year. Second, the Knicks. The Mavericks, fourth.
Well, you can't turn back the clock, Kevin, but either of these teams would be happy to relive last year in terms of their effectiveness at taking the ball away from other teams. I mean, they were amongst the league leaders in pilfering from the opponent.
First one falls for.
You know, for the better part of the history of the NBA, Kevin, the Knicks have been a fixture in the playoffs. And up until the last few years, they had missed out, but it looks like they're back now.
And a whole new group out on the floor right now for the Knicks. Dallas also making some changes. Jones comes in for Vince Carter. And it's Collison in for Delonte West. So he gets them both. Mavericks leading by three. Well, you take a look at insanity. Not sure if you guys noticed on the way in, Nike already put him up center stage on a billboard.
Well, the Make It Count ad campaign seems to have him at the center of it. He certainly made it count in the NBA so far.
Yeah, well, he's earned this endorsement, that's for sure. I mean, Nike is getting their money's worth from this guy. He's big time.
And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. On the court for the Mavericks. Insanity in at point guard.
Well done finishing that one off.
Well, it was the Dallas Mavericks winning their last game against the Raptors.
And they did just what they set out to do in that game. They were definitely the ones dictating the pace and the style.
Yeah, I'm sure it was an upbeat locker room after the game because they really did look terrific. He's got tremendous command of the game. I was able to enjoy working with him when he was with the Pacers as the head coach. He's a guy night in and night out. He's going to put his team in the best position to win based on how he operates.
Here's Insanity. Down goes the slam.
Sweet finish there, showing you some major strength and the ability to sky.
I rode that elevator right to the top floor.
Explosive hops. I'll tell you what, he can really catch you off guard.
You know, you look at the frame of Ronnie Brewer and you realize that he's perfect for defending wings. He's got incredibly long.
Look out! Watch out now! I can't imagine that we'll see one better than that tonight.
I'm with you on that, aren't you, Steve?
Oh, yeah, I'd be shocked if we saw something more entertaining than that one.
And that replay, sponsored by Sprite, giving us a great look at that one. Going back for a second to your comment, Steve, and the standoff these teams played to last year, it may have been an indicator of how closely matched the teams in the middle of both conferences were.
Well, we know these two teams were certainly closely matched.
Here's Insanity.
Call it hang time and bang time.
Unbelievable.
You got to just shake your head on that one.
Fade away. No good. Now Dallas takes it the other way. Their biggest lead of the game was 9.
Solid advantage in the rebounding totals for them so far here.
And the first half ends in a close one. Mavericks lead by one. And get ready now for the Sprint Halftime Show with Damon Bruce. The second half will be coming up right after that on 2K Sports.
Now, presented by Sprint.
And it's a good one going out in New York. Glad to have you with us for our halftime show. For the Dallas Mavericks, they have the lead against New York. They've started off pretty well this season, trying to continue the momentum. Insanity leads them in scoring. He has 12 points and has been looking really good in terms of shot selection, shooting it well from the field. On the other side, the Knicks looking pretty solid as well. A nice job of sharing the rock, making plays for one another offensively. That will be all for us. Thanks for stopping in. We'll see you next time.
Welcome back, everybody. The start of the second half getting underway. Both teams battling hard through the first half. Here's Insanity. Good. Insanity's got 14 points for the game.
And all 10 of their last points have come inside the paint, so defensively, you've got to make an adjustment.
Yeah, and you got to do a little more to stop it, too. I mean, it's coming way too easy for them. At some points, you just got to buck up and say it's not going to happen. Iman Shumpert last season started off playing at point guard for the Knicks, a position he played at Georgia Tech, but it would seem he's better off long-term at the two or three spots. More of a slasher than he is a playmaker and an excellent defender to boot.
We're all hoping he comes back from that blown knee he suffered in the playoffs against Miami.
Mm-hmm.
Looking at who's out there now for the Knicks, Marcus Camby. He's checked in for Stoudemire. And J.R. Smith subbed in for Ronnie Brewer. Here's Insanity, and it's Dallas with another.
Big mistake not having more defensive pressure on him out there.
Now, here's Collison. 6 points for him. Here's Insanity. A jump hook and another basket for Dallas.
Offensively, just hammering away in the paint.
Getting swept did not taste good. Kidd against Collison. The pass to King. Back to Collison. 6 on the shot clock. Here's Insanity. Knicks with the rebound. ...56 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. He dishes it to Carter. Down low. 5 to shoot. Insanity. An easy 2 points on the layup. Insanity's got 8 points here in this quarter. Fourth quarter getting going here. It's time for the Sprite Uncontainable Game. Doris Burke with the report. Hi, Doris.
Well, guys, the Uncontainable Game Award goes to Insanity. In a close game like this one, you have to think that it might come down to bench play, and he has been head and shoulders above everyone else in that regard.
And Doris, thank you. What a great performance indeed. Such a huge lift to your team when you can get this production from a reserve.
Yeah, in my mind, Kevin, he's been the most valuable player of this game. And when you can say that about somebody coming off the bench, I mean, that just shows you the impact that one person can have on this game.
Well, like Kevin said, it is a huge lift. I mean, I think a performance like that coming from a sub really energizes everybody else. It's contagious.
On the floor right now for the Mavericks, Insanity in a two-guard. Carter is out there with Marion. Then it's Bobon, and it's Brand in a center.
Like he rushed that one, guys. The defense was out of position. He was wide open, just couldn't take advantage.
Here's Insanity. Kicks it to Carter. The dish to Bobon. That's tipped. Taken away by Kidd. Pass to Shumpert. Teardrop shot. Insanity gets the board inside. The Mavericks leading It's off to Charlotte format for this game as they take on the Bobcats. That'll be the second of this two-game road trip.
Well, you know, that Charlotte game has a lot of attention on it, guys.
Just an unbelievable display of offense here today.
Here's Insanity. He's covered by Kidd. Insanity. Count the bucket. So no problem for New York as they get the win. How much to be critical of with this win, Clark?
Not at all. I mean, they showed up not just to play. They showed up to give great effort and to win, and they did both.
And that'll wrap it up for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan, and thanks for tuning in.
I got a million ways to get it. Choose one.
One. One, two. Check me out right here, yo.
22 points for you tonight. Although your team didn't get the win, you seem to be making your mark offensively. Is it a little frustrating knowing that you were getting the job done and some of your teammates weren't?
Nah, man. I ain't about to throw the rest of these guys under the bus like that. Basketball is a team game. We win together and we lose together. And tonight, we lost together. We just gonna have to look back and figure out what went wrong and what we're gonna do to keep that from happening again next game. Shoot, maybe I was too involved offensively. If that's the case, shoot, man, I'm happy to take a step back next time out. Whatever it takes to keep us out of the loss column, man.
Until you have a daughter, that's what I call karma. And you